It's time for baseball in the Bay Area as we welcome you to the Oakland Coliseum. Tonight we wrap up this brief two-game series between the L.A. Dodgers and the Oakland A's. Matt Olson continues his chase for the top spot on the AL batting leaderboard. Next. Trevor Cahill, the California-born right-hander, is on the mound. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, this guy's had a really solid season. And what shows me that more than anything? Solid 3-1 strikeout-to-walk ratio. And if he continues to do that, he'll pitch really well in this one.
Now to the plate is the Dodgers' designated hitter, Andrew Cole. He's assuming the role of DH in this interleague matchup.
Yeah, Matt, that's one of the funny things about National League teams playing in AL ballparks. All of a sudden, the lineup kind of changes dramatically. But the cool thing is it gives more guys a chance to get some at-bats or time in the field.
Time now to check out the lineup. For the visiting Dodgers, Dero, what you got on this lineup tonight?
Yeah, Matty, this lineup is an interesting case study. Because if you're not a big believer in batting average, this team, they're in the bottom third of batting average, so they have to do it a little bit differently. They have to move traffic and drive the baseball out of the ballpark and into the gaps. We've seen that be successful before. Let's see if it happens again today.
Here's Corey Seager, and he comes in as a player to watch out for, hitting well over 300 on the season. First pitch on its way. Easy fly ball into shallow center field. Giving chase is Powell, and that retires the side. Striding into the box, Jed Lowrie. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Leading up for the A's, the shortstop, Jed Lowrie.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And here's a first pitch curveball that bounces on him there. It's ball one. That's by him for strike one. Lowrie waits the 1-1. On the ground to the left side. And that finds its way through for a base hit. So a good start to the inning for the A's as the leadoff hitter reaches base safely. In now, Stephen Piscotty. Here comes the first pitch. Popped him up. Seager is calling for it. One away. Stepping in, Steve Lombardozzi. First swings for him in this one with a runner still at first and one gone.
Lombardozzi.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Missed with a slider. Lowrie leads off first with one away. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Taylor is there, and he makes the catch for the second out. Set to get his evening at the plate started, Chris Davis, batting just a notch below 300 so far on the season. Here's the first pitch to him. There's a fastball that just misses, ball one. Davis, sometimes called Crush with a K and an H. He was selected in the seventh round back in the 2009 MLB draft.
Man, coming out of the late rounds, you have to grind for everything. Nothing is given to you. And this guy has turned himself into a very solid big league ball player. That's a big accomplishment.
Lifted into the air out toward center field. Chasing after it is Taylor. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. So that'll bring in the National League rookie home run record holder, Cody Bellinger. A couple of hits for him in four trips to the plate last night. Up and away to start the inning. It's 1-0.
There's not too many umpires in the game that are going to ring that for a strike right there. That was borderline up, even though it was in the zone.
Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second. Now at the plate, Justin Turner, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. First offering on its way. Good breaking ball that time in for a strike.
Jumped ahead with strike one there, and that's something he's going to do a lot of in this start. He doesn't have lights out stuff, so it's important for him to be pitching ahead and have the hitters on their heels.
And that's high and off the plate, 2-1. Turner in front at 3 balls and a strike.
Well, this has been a good job to work the count from 0-1 to 3-1, and now he's really in the driver's seat to see a heater that he can do something with.
Full count, 3-2. A swing and a miss. He struck him out, and it's two up, two down to start the second. In now is Yasiel Puig. He was 1-for-4 with a triple in the ballgame last night. Lays off 1-0. Hit hard down the right field line, but that's a foul ball. The 1-1 home. On the ground near home, but that one rolls foul. The 1-2. To third. Chapman's got it. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Now the A's designated hitter, Jonathan Lucroy, as they'll have 5, 6, and 7 here to start the home half of the second. Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. A breaking ball taken on the inner corner. In his career, Lucroy carries a hitting line just over the 280 plateau. Lifted in the air to center field. Taylor is right there. One gone. That'll bring up the power hitter, Matt Olson. He had a couple of hits in that ballgame last night. Here comes the first pitch. Takes a knee-high fastball. Sharp slider that time, just missed inside. And that pitch catches the inside corner. Another slow breaking ball that misses down low.
Well, that's what you want from your curveball on 1-2. You start it in the zone and let it break out of the zone where it can't be punished. Didn't get him to go after it, but the execution was nice.
Turner is there. And that's the second out of the inning. So that'll bring in the outfielder, Bruce Powell, to try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Here's the first pitch to him. And the slider just stayed north of the strike zone that time. And he lays off a fastball here that looked pretty good, but it's 2-0.
He may be down 2-0 after those first two pitches in this AB, but those are pitches he can feel pretty good about. They didn't miss by a whole lot, so it's not like he's all over the place.
In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Bottom of the second here with no score. Line drive to left. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. So that keeps the bottom of the second going. Into the box now, Josh Begley. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. First pitch of the at-bat. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Kemp on the run. He's got it. A great running play, and that'll retire the side. Into the box, Matt Kemp. 7-8-9, bottom of the order set to go here in the third. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. A knee-high sinker. Tough pitch. Strike one. Swung on, but it's pulled foul wide of third. Another 0-2 coming. Grounded to short. And the throw will get him at first. How about that by Jed Lowry? That'll bring in Austin Barnes. First pitch coming. Here it is. Leaves a changeup high for a strike.
We're seeing him in an absolute groove out there in the mound right now. Retired seven straight, and mechanically, he looks really consistent and fluid to me.
1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Ready to deliver the 1-2. Liner towards second. Uh-oh, missed it. Digging in the switch hitter, Henry Sanchez. Second. He'll get to take his first cuts
Henry
here.
Sanchez.
Throw over to the bag, and the runner back easily. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Hard hit to first. Lowry. Relay to first in time, and just like that, this side is retired. Now to the plate, Matt Chapman, as we move on to the bottom of inning number three.
Third baseman, Chapman.
Here comes the first pitch. Hit in the air to left field. Catch made out there by Kemp, and there's one gone. Digging in for his second at-bat, Jed Lowry. He reached on a single in his first try. Here's the pitch. Nowhere close with the fastball to begin the at-bat. It's ball one. There's a drive out toward the alley in right center. Lowry will take the turn and hit for second. And he is in at second base with a one-out double. Digging in now, Stephen Piscotty. So far, 0-for-1 with a flyout. Here's the first pitch to him. Now a swing and a fly ball. Puig on the run, but no one can get to this one as it's down for a foul ball inside the visitor's bullpen. Now the 0-1. Hit on the ground out to short. Seager takes it in. And there are two away now. Striding in, Steve Lombardozzi. 0-for-1 here in the early going. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Line toward the alley in left center. And that's going to get down out there. Now a long throw home. And this will not be close, and the run will score. easily. Here's Chris Davis now, trying to keep things going now with a runner at first following the RBI single. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Slider's in for a strike.
Oh, he thanks his lucky stars right there getting away with that hanger. I cannot believe he didn't pull the trigger on that pitch.
That's a ball.
And a fastball just below the knees, ball one. Into the corner and slicing foul. The 1-2 is swung on and missed. He got him. Striding forward now is the DH. Andrew Thomas comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. First pitch of the at bat on its way. Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field. So the Dodgers get their leadoff hitter on base to kick off the inning. So coming to the plate, Chris Taylor hit it hard but lined out in his first at-bat. Prior to the at-bat, a check on first, but the runner's back easily. First pitch on its way. Knee-high slider that he takes a look at. And he misses with it, 1-1. Coles aboard here at first with nobody out. The 1-1 is looked at for ball number two. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
I know this team has been struggling offensively, but here's a perfect situation with a 3-1 count. You have a chance to do some damage. You know you're getting guaranteed play.
And that's through for a base hit. Make him 1-for-2 in this one. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. And they're not going to get him as he's in there to score. Next up for Los Angeles, Corey Seager. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far. From the stretch, here's the pitch. And the changeup is way low that time. A dangerous changeup left high, but called for a strike. Hit back up the middle. Throw on to first, and one shortstop grounds out to the other, one away. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Cody Bellinger. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Here's the first pitch to him. Squared that one up just a little late. And facing right-handed pitching so far this season, Bellinger is holding on to a batting average way down in the 210s.
Yeah, Matty, he's well aware of it. Runners in scoring position, that's where you need to be on your game. He's just expanded the zone entirely too much in these situations.
Swing, and there it goes. Deep to left field. And out of here, and I mean by plenty. That ball was crushed. So striding in, Justin Turner. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Here it comes. And this one's not close. It's in the dirt for ball one. Slider right over the middle, taken for a strike. Now the 1-1 pitch. And he misses, 2-1.
Well, I think he just kind of lost focus on the mound right there. It's clearly not going his way, and he's thinking more about that than the task at hand. And right now, he needs to think about this hitter.
He's ready with the 2-2 pitch. And that's off his leg on the mound. So gets him. So they are able to get an out on an unusual play. Hopefully the pitcher's okay. Now batting, Yasiel Puig. First delivery to him on the way. And that misses for ball one. This is line to left.
Davis
is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. Next up for the A's, Jonathan Lucroy. Over one for him here in this one.
Hey, we're still in the early stages in this one. They're only down by a couple of runs. But it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
Here's a high pop-up. Sanchez has it, and it's a quick out number one. That'll bring up the power hitter, Matt Olson. He popped out in his first trip. He's ready. Here's the first offering. And here's a slider that's nowhere close, and it's 1-0. Takes a look at one catching the outside corner.
Hey, this is the game within the game right here. The hitter has to decide if he's going to change his game plan. Is he going to stay staunch and wait for him to miss over the heart of the plate or inside? Or is he going to adjust his sights and try and drive the ball the other way?
And Kemp will look this one in for out number two.
Number three.
So that'll bring in the outfielder, Boone Powell. One for one after a single his first time up. Here comes the first pitch. A high fastball is in there.
Yeah, I'm shocked he let that first pitch go right there. High fastball, but usually those ones travel the furthest.
High in the air out to center field. Taylor is there. And that's the third out. So here's Matt Kemp now. He'll start off the fifth in this one.
Left fielder, Matt Kemp.
First pitch on its way. And that one just missed outside. Left side of the infield into the shift. Played on the backhand. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away. Ready now, Austin Barnes. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. A swing and a miss on a ball that jammed him. Just got a piece up the line. Chapman has it cleanly. Throw on to first, and Cahill's looking sharp here. Two away. Digging in, Henry Sanchez. As the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Checks his swing, but this pitch is right there for strike one. And here's a swing and a miss as he falls behind nothing and two. Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. Fouled off.
You're grinding so hard at the plate right there, expecting something on the corners, and what happens? Change up, middle cut. Your eyes light up, but you're just not able to barrel it up.
Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. The 1-2. down the first baseline. Well, this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Skied in the air to straightaway left.
After it is Davis. And that ends the inning. So stepping in, Josh Begley. He flew out in his last at bat.
Things not looking very good so far in this one, but we're still in the middle innings. They're down by a couple of runs, and this would be the right place and the right time to get something going. The last thing they want to do is to try to come from behind and win this one in the eighth or ninth inning.
And this one's downstairs. It's a ball and a strike. Starts to go around, but the home plate umpire says he held up ball two. This is lined to left. And that's a base hit. One for two in his first couple of plate appearances. So that puts the leadoff man aboard to get the inning underway.
Now batting.
So that brings up the always intense Matt Chapman. So far, 0 for 1 with a flyout. Here's the first pitch to him. Missed with a breaking ball. And here's a pitch inside, and that got him. Here's Jed Lowry now. Two hits and two trips more than thus far.
Shortstop, Jed Lowry.
First offering on its way. And a fastball just a bit high. Now the 1-0. There's a fastball that misses.
Boy, he better get it back together here quick because he's got two guys on already. He's starting to lose location of that strike zone. He's got to throw a strike right here.
Ready with the 2-0 pitch. Down low, and the plot thickens here. 3-0.
He's been throwing strikes all day, so you're not up at the plate thinking he's going to walk you in this situation. You need to be aggressive and sit hard at the plate.
A strike, and it's 3-1.
3-1 with 2 on, and this is where you got to be geared up for something to drive. I don't think you can just groove him one right here. You still have to try to make a competitive pitch.
High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Sanchez will stay with it as he backs up and puts it away. One gone.
Now back.
Outfielder Stephen Piscotty the next to hit. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. There's a strike. And that one just missed outside. And he chased up and out of the zone. A swing and a miss.
Yeah, Matty, not only is this guy using all four quadrants, he's elevating, getting their eye level up with a quality fastball.
Here's a looping fly ball out to right. Puig will come in a bit and put it away for the second out of the inning. Now at the plate, Steve Lombardozzi. He singled his last time up.
Steve Lombardozzi.
Looking to wiggle out of this. Here it is. And he takes a cold strike. 0-1. Has a look. Now the pitch. Big swing and a miss at the fastball. And he's behind in the count. 0-2.
Some guys have no trouble hitting with two strikes, and some guys never want to get there. Let's see the approach right here. I'd like to see him shorten up a little bit, maybe choke up and try and work the ball back up the middle the other way.
On to first, and the A's fail to cash in here as the side is retired. And that'll bring in the speedy left-handed hitter, Andrew Toll. He'll stand in against Trevor Cahill to get the inning underway. First delivery to him on the way. Belt high and right down the middle for a strike. Aims a changeup high for a strike.
Hey, you find yourself down 0-2. You've got to grind a little bit right here. I don't understand the game plan. Let's see if we can get this one back to even count.
And he'll step on first himself for the out. Now at the plate, Chris Taylor. He's 1-for-2 in this one. First pitch of the at-bat. To the left side, but it's well foul. Heading out towards shallow right. In comes Piscotty, and that's the second out of the inning. Here's Corey Seager. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. First offering on its way. Takes a look at a strike over the inside corner.
You know, guys, sometimes guys don't like pulling the trigger 0-0. They want to see something go by, calibrate the speed, calibrate the break, and then make their adjustments off that. Maybe that's the case right here.
Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. And strike three called as he says, you got to be kidding me, with the side retired. Here's Chris Davis now. He's 0-for-2 thus far in this one.
Left fielder, Chris Davis.
First delivery to him on the way. And a fastball just below the knees, ball one. Hit high and deep to straightaway right field. Back goes Puig to the track. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Next will be the designated hitter, Jonathan Lucroy. 0-for-2 on his line thus far. First pitch coming. Here it is. Liner towards second, but right to the second baseman, and that's the second out. So digging in now, Matt Olson. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point. Here comes the first pitch. A changeup over the inside corner. Him up, but this will land untouched. One run, five hits, and no errors in the ball game for the A's so far. And an off-speed pitch swung on and missed, and with that, the side is retired. Back here at the Coliseum in Oakland. The men in blue leading in this one as we get set to begin the seventh. But before we do, let's check out the game summary to this point. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. This gets foul. It's 0-1. Had him reaching at thin air that time, and he's very quickly down 0-2. And the sinking fastball called strike three, and that's out number one. Next for the Dodgers, Justin Turner. He started out the evening 0 for 2 so far. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Lowry to play this one at short. Reined in on to first, and it's a quick start to the seventh as now there are two away. Now at the plate, Yasiel Puig hit the ball pretty well in his last at-bat, but it resulted in a line-out. Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. Swing and a little tapper, but it's foul, strike one. A 1-1 count to Puig. Three runs, four hits. No errors for the Dodgers thus far. A bouncer up the middle. And there's his first base hit in this one. So good work on a 1-2 count to get on base. So it's a runner at first with two men out. And stepping forth is the left fielder, Matt Kemp. First pitch of the at-bat. Takes a look at one catching the outside corner. Swings through it for strike number two.
You know, we haven't seen that pitch from him in a while, but it looks like he's got pretty good feel for it. If he's going to pick and choose when he's going to use it, he could steal some strikes out.
And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Stepping in and ready for another shot. Hit in two tries so far.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast. They could certainly use that right now.
First pitch of the at-bat. And that one right down Main Street.
Guys, I've been really impressed with him tonight. I mean, he's carving these guys up with all of his pitches.
Arched up on the corner, and he's got him 0-2 now. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. A little bouncer. That ball's foul, so a good job to fight it off and stay alive.
That wasn't a terrible pitch right there, but if he's going to execute and get this swing and a miss, he's going to have to get that ball a little bit further down, maybe even potentially bounce the next time.
Looking to put him away. Here's the 0-2. Up around the face. Well, he's having a good amount of success here, Dan, even though he hasn't really gotten a ton of swings and misses.
Yeah, but for him, Matt, he's more of a pitch-to-contact kind of guy, and obviously it's working so far, and the way he pitches, it really keeps his pitch count down.
The 2-2. And there's one well above the zone for a ball.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2. But when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone, it's obviously easy to take that one.
Got him to miss the breaking ball there. Luke Powell is retired for the first out in the bottom half of the seventh inning. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. No balls and a strike to count. We're in the seventh inning with a good finish brewing. 3-1 our score. And this will ricochet off of him on the mound. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely. Riding in once again, Matt Chapman. He was drilled by a pitch his last time up. Here's the first pitch to him. And he'll try to crowd him there to start the at-bat. It's 1-0. The 1-0 is in there for strike one. A And this pitch runs in and hits him, but not before he swings through it. Not sure what he was thinking about that time, but it's 1-2 now. The 1-2. He swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. So it's a runner at first with two men out, and that'll bring in the shortstop, Jed Lowry. He's set, and the pitch. A high fastball is in there. The 0-1 on its way. Just a bit high that time as he misses for a ball. Cue shot here out towards short. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Fernando Rodney has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
56, Fernando Rodney.
At the plate, Austin Barnes. He'll have a new pitcher waiting for him as we begin their half of the eighth. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Swing, high drive, left field and deep. Nearly a big fly to start the inning. Instead, a foul ball. Set to deliver the 0-1. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Here comes the nothing and two pitch. That misses, says the home plate umpire. 1-2. Where it misses, I'm not quite sure. And he got him. Digging in to try it again, Henry Sanchez. He comes in 0-2 thus far.
Henry Sanchez.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. A changeup that catches the corner for strike one.
Good pitch right there from the reliever. Tough for hitters to do much with pitches in that location unless they're looking for it.
Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen. First delivery to him on the way. Comes right after him with a fastball for a strike. Missed with a slider. A 1-1 is a changeup that's looked at for a ball. A wave and a miss, a tick behind a good fastball.
He's going to need to shorten up and get that foot down a little bit earlier if he hopes to be catching up to that fastball.
Hit out towards second. Lombardozzi scoops it up, throw in time, and the side is retired. Adam Liberatore is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 36, Adam Liberatore.
Now in the box, Stephen Piscotty. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Right fielder, Stephen Piscotty.
First pitch on its way. Takes a look down at the knees for a strike.
Tying run stands on deck, but it'll only matter if the guy in the box can get on base.
Yeah, and that has to be his mentality at the plate right now, Matt. He can't be the hero, so he needs to do what he can to give the guy behind him a chance to be the guy.
And on 0-2, he misses with a fastball.
Boy, it's hard to sit on an 0-2 fastball. I think that pitch just locked him up a bit. But lucky for him, it was just a little out of the zone.
And he takes strike three called on the fastball. One gone.
Second baseman, Team Lombardozzi.
Here's the first pitch to him. And this is lifted high in the air down the right field line. But this will wind up being a foul ball. And he takes this one high, 1-1. And a slider runs in on him as he has to lean out of the way. Never tempted to swing at that ball down low. It's ball three.
3-1 count, tying run on the on-deck circle. You have to be very careful right here to make a quality pitch on 3-1.
The 3-2 pitch. Little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. The next 3-2. Very weakly on the ground. That veers foul, so they'll do it again on 3-2. Towards second. And that falls in for a solid base hit, his second of the night. Here's Chris Davis now. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once.
Chris Davis.
Set, here it comes. There's a knee-high pitch that catches the zone. There's a fastball that just misses. Ball one. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Taylor is there. And he brings it in for the second out of the inning. Kenley Jansen enters the game in a save situation, but he'll be asked to get four outs here instead of the standard three. Jonathan Lucroy will be the first to greet him here as he stands in with a runner at first and two away. Bruce Maxwell will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Number 13,
Bruce Maxwell.
And too high with the cut fastball. It's 1-0 now. The 1-0 delivery. Outside with the cut fastball there, and it's a two-ball count. The 2-0 pitch. 3-0 now.
That's where he wants that sinker to end up, but that was a nice job of laying off.
Here's the 3-0 pitch. Liner toward right center. That gets down, and the inning continues. And that. runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now. So they'll go to the bullpen now, and it'll be the left-hander here to face the upcoming left-handed batter. Matt Olson will be his first assignment here as he'll face him with runners at first and second and two away. Cingrani pauses. Here's the first pitch. Good changeup that time, but he wouldn't bite on it. That one's going to find the seats. Strike one. The 1-1 home is taken for ball two. Cingrani offers up perhaps one of the nastiest sliders around, and it won't be uncommon to see a lot of off-balance swings against it, and it'll be easy to see why once you see it come out of his hand. He's got a huge break on it. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Kemp has a read on it, makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. Standing in, Chris Taylor. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. A ball and no strikes. The 1-0. Finds the zone. Strike one. A shot out to right center field. He threw first and hustling for second. And a good way to start the ninth as he's in with a leadoff double. Here's Corey Seager.
Corey Seager.
Here comes the first pitch. Swung on and missed. It's 0-1.
0-1's the count.
Fastball that just misses inside. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Piscotty's there for it. He gets there to put it away, but the runner tags and breaks for third. And he'll make it up to third safely here with one away. So that'll bring in the National League rookie home run record holder, Cody Bellinger. With past history with Fernando Rodney, he's hitless in three at-bats. Is Merrill Petit enters the game with now one gone in the top of inning number nine.
Number 36, Merrill Petit.
first pitch on its way. There's a fastball right over the inside corner.
Hey, I don't have a problem with him taking a pitch right there. It's a good opportunity to see what he's got. Also a good opportunity to see if he's going to be pounding the strike zone. If you can work a couple walks, it could be the start of a big inning.
Good job of holding up on the low ball there, and it's 1-2.
Petit,
a 6-foot-1-inch right-hander. He's a veteran of 13 years at the major league level, which really points to the consistency he's shown since he first broke in. So he ran the fastball by him for the punch-out. Cody Bellinger goes down for out number 2 in the top of the ninth. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. The cutter runs outside, ball 1. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Lombardozzi is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great job there of working out a potential trouble. Yimi Garcia enters the game to finish this one off here in the bottom of the ninth.
Number 63, Yimi Garcia.
Ready for another chance?
Boog Powell.
He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Boog Powell.
Here comes the first pitch. Takes a high fastball for a strike. Changeup gets him out in front for strike 2.
Boy, he juked him out of his shoes with that changeup. Stood almost no chance of doing anything with it, but it probably looked good coming in.
Sent on the ground out to second. And there's one down now. So striding forward now, Josh Begley. He's 2-for-3 thus far.
Begley.
First delivery to him on the way. And that slider's almost in the dirt. Takes a knee-high fastball. A big pass at a slider that gets past him. Hit to short. Oh, look at the sliding stop. The throw to first. What a way to get it out. Two gone now. That was exceptional.
How about it?
Settling in now, Matt Chapman. And he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the ninth. First pitch on its way. A slider that just grabs the outside corner. Well hit. Deep down the right field line. And that is off the wall, but in foul territory. Foul ball. Last strike now for Oakland. Just a touch outside. 1-2.
Well, you don't want to get caught looking for the final out. That's a tough pitch to lay off. Impressive that he did.
And he lays off the pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
Wow, from 0-2 to 3-2, and that last pitch on 2-2 wasn't even close. He had this guy in the ropes, but...
Throw on to first is going to be in time for the final out, and the Dodgers have claimed the fourth consecutive victory here as this ball game is over. Well, we watched a really...